This is EY's stream. He thinks he looks pretty cool, but ProGamer27 doesn't think so. Please make him feel better and follow his Instagram and Twitter. Go! Go do it now! Hey, what's up guys? EY Stream back here with another Minecraft video. And today guys, you may notice there is a house behind me. Well, unless you're blind. Also, how you managed to miss the giant house behind me. And if you did that, you might want to see a doctor about that because, I mean, it's pretty big and obvious. But anyway, guys, it's a pretty nice house. I mean, you got to agree, it's pretty big, it's roomy, it's got a garden, and honestly, it's pretty awesome. In fact, by my building standards, it is a full-on mansion because, let's be real, guys, I really can't build. It's pretty cool. But, not gonna lie, I don't like it. Yeah, it's not because it's a bad house, it's just, it's not my style, guys. It's got that really bright red roof. I'd prefer if the garden had red roses, to be honest, and all round. You know, it doesn't suit me, guys. Now, normally in Minecraft, if something like this happened, it'd just be unlucky, tough luck. Either that, or you could go ahead and destroy the entire flipping roof, and then redo it yourself. And honestly, that's kind of ridiculous, guys. But today's video, that's all about to change. I'm about to blow your mind, because from now on, guys, when you want to go ahead and customize a house, all you're going to have to do is hit a button. As simple as that, guys. As if you were crafting a mansion in a crafting table, guys. Because when you're just hitting a button, it is as easy as crafting a house. In fact, I would literally call this crafting a house, except not in a crafting table, but cooler, guys. So all you're going to have to do, guys, believe it or not, is hit a button and you'll be able to customize any aspect of your house. It's insane. It's crazy, guys. But I'm really excited to show this to you. So if you are as well, make sure to drop a like down below. We're going for 2,000 likes on today's video, guys. And if you are new to the channel and you are like, how in the world are we going to customize our house to our liking? Well, hold on, guys. You gotta wait till the end of the video. Make sure to go ahead and slap the subscribe button, hit the little bell icon, ding, 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 to never miss an upload, guys. And before we get in, I know I've been talking for a bit, but I have some really, really exciting news, guys. My Minecraft Pocket Edition realm is now public once again. So if you guys want to join that and come play with me, all you got to do is subscribe and hit the bell. And then after today's video, go hit the link in the description below, guys, and fill out a form. It's like, it'll just be like, oh, what's your name? Well, how old are you? Are you subscribed? All that good stuff, guys. And once you fill out that form, you will get an email with your exclusive sign-up code to join my realm and come play with me. I really want to see you guys there, so make sure to go ahead and hit that link in the description below after today's video to come play Minecraft with me on my realm. But I've done enough talking. Let's go ahead and check this out for ourselves. Now, I'm sure you guys saw when I did the quick, you know, view change. There is all this behind me. Now, this is basically the crafting table for houses, guys. It's a ton of funky little buttons that allow us to customize every single aspect of our house, down to the flooring, guys. So if we come into a house, guys, it's a pretty nice house. We have like these trapdoors, which honestly just look like chocolate blocks in my opinion, and they make me very, very hungry. And just kind of have a look around the house at the moment, guys. We've got a cobblestone floor, white concrete bench. We've got a nice little fireplace over here, and upstairs we have some beds, some prismarine stairs. It's pretty cool, guys, and all around. You know, as I said before, it's actually a really nice house, but with these buttons, guys, it's going to allow us to craft our house the way we want it, guys, to craft this into a mansion worthy of me. Or you guys. However you want to customize your mansion, you can now do that just at the click of a button. So the first thing I think I remember saying at the intro, guys, is I kind of wish we had red flowers. And check it out, guys. It's as simple as if I go ahead and click the red flower button, bang, and kaboom! Check it out, guys. All the yellow flowers have just turned into red flowers, just like that, with a snap of the fingers, guys. It is actually insane. So let's say we wanted sunflowers, hit the button, and bang, guys. They just instantly turn into sunflowers. There's no delay, nothing. It just happens. I don't even know how this works, guys. Some sort of command block magic. You guys want to check this out, make sure to click the link in the description below. I will have the download link there, guys, so you can go ahead and customize your very own house. But for the most part, we're going to start checking out all the different ways we can customize this house. So let's go ahead and put it back on red flowers, because personally, I think they look the best. Now, our next one is countertops for the inside. So I believe they were white concrete before. Let's try wood and see what that looks like, guys. So we'll head in here. Oh, yeah. So as you guys can see, all our countertops have turned from white concrete to wood. And honestly, I think that looks pretty cool. What was our other option, guys? I want to check out all the options we got. So down here, guys, we got iron as well. Let's have a quick squeeze at what this looks like. Oh, yeah. Okay, the iron's probably my favorite. I think that blends in the best. So I'm going to leave that on iron there, guys. I kind of like that. Now, our next option. Oh, guys, this is so cool. The fact that you're able to customize the house just like that. Normally, if you wanted to redo something like this, you'd have to dig it all up. And then you'd have to get all the resources to redo it all. But with this, it's just like a click of a button, guys. It's like as easy as crafting. It is crazy. So, wall block under roof chimney block outside. What is this? Just if I click sand? Oh, yo, this is like the chimney and like those little blocks under the roof. Dang, sand actually looks pretty good for a chimney, but also I don't feel like having glass, having sand and fire together is a great option. So what about clay, guys? Okay, no. Clay is definitely my favorite. I'm going to stick with clay there. Now, our next one is the indoor flooring. Now, I believe that was cobblestone before. Let's try nether brick, guys, and have a look at what this looks like. Ooh, I like this. Then it matches the stairs, and it looks like... I actually really like the look of nether brick, guys. And obviously, in survival, I would never be able to get this much nether brick. This looks really, really... Actually, yeah, this is definitely... I'm sticking with nether brick. I think nether brick looks really, really awesome. All right, what else can we customize here, guys? Windows. So, we can click this one. And, oh, I see. So, you guys can see that now all our windows are paned. So, if we come here, we go ahead and we can make them... if we hit that button, that'll make them a block just like that, guys. If you like panes more, you can go ahead, hit that, and all our windows will turn into panes. And then, finally, guys, we have white stained glass if, you know, stained glass is your kind of jam. Personally, I think panes look super sophisticated, so I'm going to go ahead and grab some of those so I just look classy. But, yeah, we got those panes. Now, our next one, guys, is the wooden frame of the house. As you guys can see, we got the acacia wood. Personally, oak is generally my favorite, and I think that looks really good. But then there's this funky little log. I think this is a stripped acacia log. I'm really curious. What is that? Yo, that looks super funky, guys. Like, honestly, there is no other block like this. And even though I'm not a huge fan of how it looks with the roof at the moment, just because of how unusual that block looks, I think I'm going to keep that. Now, our next one is the leaves on the outside. So if you want the leaves to become sponges, well, you can. You can... Honestly, guys, this custom house, you could honestly try and make the ugliest house you can, and it would look hilarious, guys. You can also go ahead and switch the leaves over to emerald blocks, but personally, I think leaves definitely look the best. Now, what else can we customize, guys? I'm honestly having so much fun. Once again, if you want to try this for yourself, download the link in the description. But we've also got the chairs. Oh, those are like the prismarine blocks. So I think I didn't like the prismarine, but I'm going to go ahead and try the endstone. So as you guys can see, these all switch to our endstone blocks there. I don't think they're called endstone blocks. I can't remember what they're called. But I think they're purple stairs. But honestly, the purple looks really, really nice with our nether brick flooring. So I think I'm going to stick with the nether brick and the purple combination. I think that looks really cool. The only thing it does look a little strange is out here having purple blocks. But whatever, guys. I think it looks kind of cool. So there's our purple block, guys. Now, our next one is the carpets on the inside of the house. So obviously there's the wool carpets, but we can also switch over to diamonds. Because if you're feeling like being super rich and just flexing on all of your friends, guys, now you can see all our carpets have become diamond blocks. And once again, I think diamonds actually look pretty funky with the nether brick flooring. So I'm going to go ahead and stick with diamonds. I know, guys, I'm really basic, but diamonds are pretty awesome. So I'm going to stick with diamonds, but you can also get hay bales, which is interesting. Now we've also got the roofing, which is what I wanted to change. We'll switch that over to wood, I think. Nope. Okay, wood looks ugly. How about quartz, guys? Quartz also looks a little bit weird, guys. I don't know. I think I'm going to have to switch the... I switch this back to acacia. Okay, that looks a little better if I'm using the acacia instead of that red strip log, guys. So the quartz and the acacia log, I think, look really, really cool together. So I'm going to hang those together. We can also go ahead and change our wall so we can go sandstone. Oh, I like that. That gives it like a really kind of modern desert vibe. But we also got brick. How does that... Okay, no. I think I'm going to hang with the sandstone here, guys. I think that looks pretty funky. We've got the fences. So at the moment, we're using the cobblestone walls. If I switch that over to iron bars, I kind of like that, but not so much. And then fences. I think the cobblestone wall definitely looked the best. And finally, guys, we've got the small pond in front. So as you guys can see, I think that's this stuff here. If we go ahead and switch that to water, as you guys... Yep, it was. Yeah, as you guys can see, now it's water, which honestly I think is the best. But you can also go ahead and if you're feeling like making a winter-style house, you can switch it over to ice. But I'm going to definitely keep it water there, guys. So now that we've customized our house, let's go ahead and see what it looks like, guys. So, of course, we have our pond here. Let's come on the inside. We have the nether brick and the sandstone. I don't think the nether brick and the sandstone work together so well. So I'm going to go ahead and switch that over right now because apparently that was not the best design decision I make. So I'll switch it over to cobblestone again and then we'll switch the carpets back to... Actually, we might go with hay bales. Hay bales are a really interesting thing. I've never seen them used as decorations before, but honestly, that looks pretty cool. I actually really, really dig that style, guys. So as you guys can see, you can go ahead and customize this house however you want and really make it your own, guys. Make it suit you. And of course, guys, you can customize things the old-fashioned way. So if you don't like that skull, you just go ahead and destroy it. It's that simple, guys. And at the end of the day, you can make a house that really feels your own without having to do a lot of work and testing things around, guys. All you gotta do is hit buttons as if you're crafting your very own house. Now that we've done that, guys, I think there's one thing I've been wanting to do all video, and that's see what is the ugliest house we can make, guys. So, first off, I'm not a huge fan of sunflowers, so we're gonna make them all sunflowers. Then we're going to make the countertops wood. We're going to make this. We're gonna make that sand, and then we're gonna make this prismarine, and just like that. We're going to use white stained glass. We're going to use those red strip logs because honestly, I do not like the look of them, I've decided. We're going to use sponges as leaves. That's a little funky, guys. We're going to use bricks. We're going to use diamond blocks as our carpet. We're going to use bricks for our walls. We're going to use iron bars. And finally, the podzol there, guys. So check it out, guys. I think I've officially made the ugliest house in Minecraft ever just by hitting a few buttons. Holy moly. So as you can see, we've got the podzol. We got with these weird iron bar fences. We have like brick walls and chairs, I think. And then we also have the really weird stone and a sand chimney. And when we come in here, what the flip have I done, guys? Holy moly, this thing is ugly. 10 out of 10, ugliest thing I've ever done in Minecraft. We got prismarine floor, diamond carpet. Honestly, what have I done? This looks so strange, guys. Oh my gosh. All right. Anyway, guys. All around, this is a really, really cool map. I would definitely recommend checking it out, guys. If I switch into creative right now, I'm kind of curious what's making this all run. I'm pretty sure, all right, yeah. So there's a bunch of command blocks that are making this map run. It's pretty impressive. So if you guys do want to check this out and get your very own customizable house that you can craft to your liking for yourself, guys, make sure to hit the download link in the description below, guys. I hope you have enjoyed today's video. I'll see you in the next one. And until then, guys, you ice cream out. We'll be right back.